Happy New Year. Welcome to 2022. Welcome to the second Sunday of Christmas here at Love of Christ Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Steve Talmadge, and along with Pastor Nanette Christofferson, we're glad that you're joining us either in person or online today. We also welcome Joy Kleesner, who's playing the bassoon for us. It's a gift to our worship today. And we also welcome Kevin and Aaron Anderson's family, as we're going to celebrate at this service the baptism of Miles Thomas later in the service. So we are glad that you're here, and we pray that 2022 is going to be a wonderful year. We encourage you to check out our website and e-news for upcoming faith formation and faith in action opportunities. We want to offer a thank you to all the volunteers who spent last week hosting, feeding, and staying overnight as we had five families being sheltered and taken care of through the Family Promise partnership that we have here. So thank you for that. Let's now quiet our minds. Let's focus our attention on God as Joey offers music today.
Thank you.
Let's now focus our attention on confession and forgiveness. We gather this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We take a moment of silence for reflection and self-examination. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. And for his sake, God forgives us all our sin. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, I therefore declare to each of you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We now listen to Amazing Grace as Joey offers it. Thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Jesus Christ, light of life, shine in your people here.
Jesus Christ, light of life, shine in your people here.
Stay with us now, put fear to flight as morning ushers in the day. Almighty God, you have filled all the earth with the light of your incarnate word. By your grace, empower us to reflect your light in all that we do. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. Our worship continues with our readings from God's word.
Good morning, and Happy New Year. And please note, during the year, any problems you face, our Lord is standing there with you. Amen. The first lesson today comes from Jeremiah, chapter 31. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I'm going to bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labor, together a great company. They shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolation I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water in a straight path in which they shall not stumble, for I have become a father of Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather them and will keep them as a shepherd a flock. For the Lord has ransomed Jacob and has redeemed him with hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord, over the grain, the wine, and the oil, and over the young of the flock and the herd. Their life shall become like a watered garden, and they shall never languish again. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them goodness for sorrow. I will give the priests their fill of fatness, and my people shall be satisfied with my bounty, says the Lord. The second reading comes from Ephesians chapter 1. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He designed for us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. In him we have redeemed through his blood the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on the earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory in him. When you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of our salvation, and believed in him, were marked by the seal of his promised Holy Spirit. This is his pledge in our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people to the praise of his glory. Here ends the reading of the lessons. Please stand for the gospel.
Looked with favor Our gospel reading this morning comes from John chapter 1, verses 1 to 18. Glory to you, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. And all things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being, in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.'" From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Good morning, and Happy New Year. Many of us know that words carry oftentimes confusion, or words can lead to misunderstanding. I'd like to give a few examples from church newsletters and bulletins. Now, mind you, this is not from our e-news or our bulletins. One read, "When you come this afternoon, please be ready to pray and we'll offer medication." Another read, "After church today, there will be two meetings, one at the north end and one at the south end, and children will be baptized at both ends." And yet another read, "Thursday night is our Bible study night. The topic is, what is hell? Please come and listen to our choir practice." When we take a look at words, words can easily be misconstrued and misunderstood and used to manipulate, used to fool. Perhaps our media is queen or king of that, or our politicians, or even advertising. For how many times a week do you get things in the mail that say, "Urgent, urgent reply requested, your such and such will be expired." And you look at the company and you're like, "I don't even have insurance with that company." Words are often misleading. In this case, misleading us to a scam. And if we go back to our playground days, if we go back to when we were children, and this famous saying that was said, "Sticks and stones may break our bones, but words will never hurt us." Well, that's a flat-out lie. For bones often heal faster than the sting of someone's words of criticism. Words are powerful. Words are so powerful that they can hurt us desperately. And on the flip side, words are so powerful that they can bring a healing to us in a way that nothing else can. How many times have we said words of regret, words that have just popped out of our mouth, And as quickly as they were said, we wish we could just shove them right back in. Because words of regret are often the hardest to reconcile. But then there are the words that we tell ourselves, the words that maybe other people tell us, words that aren't true, words that we tell ourselves that we can't do something or be something. Instead, we should be believing in the one who brings to us his word of truth, that we are loved by him. Would you please pray with me? Lord God, you are the author of our universe. You are the creator of humankind. May your word speak life into us this day. Father, Spirit, Jesus, may you enter into the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts, and may it be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Grace and peace to you from the one who brings us light and love. Amen. We have before us today a beautiful word, beautiful words from Scripture that take us all the way back to the beginning. This gospel writer, John, wants to make it known to us of God's overarching plan of grace and love that has come into the world through this incarnational birth of Christ. This is exciting. This word has become flesh. This is amazing words from God, words that are so beautiful that hymns have been made to these words, words that sound like a poem. And these words tell us what God's intentions are through the word. And in our reading today, we hear these words that bring to us hope and promise, that demonstrate God's faithfulness to us, as we hear that the word has come to be light in our darkness. Light that cannot be extinguished. Light that cannot be overcome by darkness. That the Word has become flesh and dwells among us. This Word has tented. This Word has become a tabernacle. This Word has come to be in us. We also learn that this word has come to his own people, and yet his own people do not accept him. That this word is full of grace and truth, and that this word has come to bring light and life to all people. That this word is inclusive, that this word is for everyone. And that in his fullness, in the fullness of his word, we receive grace upon grace. That's the power of God's word becoming flesh. That's the power of God's word in Jesus Christ, who became flesh to dwell among us, to be the light of the world. As we look to these words, they offer us words of hope, words of promise, words of grace. And we see that our gospel writer is inviting us into an experience, inviting us into an encounter with God. And we see this throughout the Gospel of John. We see this when Jesus declares that I am the bread of life. As Jesus feeds the multitudes, people encounter him. I'd like us today to think about two words. I'd like us to think about the word experience, and I'd like us to think about the word encounter. And in your mind, just kind of come up with a little definition. As you think about the word experience, experience is something that we are a spectator in. We might go to the Cardinals football game and we are a spectator as we watch that game. But an encounter is something different. An encounter requires an interaction. An encounter almost requires or demands a response. An encounter changes us. An encounter is something that we are taken by surprise. It's unexpected. So as we think about these two words, and maybe, yes, I might be pulling hairs at the semantics between experience and encounter, God has invited us through this Gospel of John today to encounter him in the Word made flesh. And as I said earlier, we can see this encountering through the Gospel of John. We can see this grace upon grace through the Gospel of John. And we see this as Jesus encounters others. Jesus encounters others who are a little confused by how God wants to be connected to them. So he explains to them that he is the vine and we are the branches. People walked away from hearing Jesus' words with an encounter changed by that. Changed by the power of knowing that this God wants a relationship with us. Richard Rohr, in his book, What the Mystics Know, tells us that an encounter is something different. An encounter isn't always what we expect God to be. In fact, what we think God is, God usually isn't, he writes. And an encounter is unexpected, oftentimes happening at a moment of great pain, as God is molding us and shaping us into a new way, a new creation, a new way of being. Jose Altervez was a college sophomore a few years ago at the University of Florida. And while there, he saw at the dorms an advertisement, something that said they needed mentors in the Boys and Girls Club of America. So he went there. And they talked to him, and they assigned him a child. He was given a little boy who was 7 years old, and his name was Jaden. Jaden had been in foster care for 6 of his 7 years of life, changing from one house to another to another. Jaden had many problems. Jaden didn't know how to self-regulate. He found himself in trouble a lot. He found himself in fights a lot with other kids. Because he didn't use words, instead he used fists or his feet to kick others. As Jose met Jaden, Jaden wanted nothing to do with him. He didn't want his help. He didn't want anything to do with him. This happened time after time until it was revealed to Jose that Jaden really liked Skittles. And Jose said it didn't matter how many Skittles he brought, whether it was 1 or 10, he was in with Jaden. As he and Jaden began to build a relationship, he walked into the center one day and he found that Jaden was in timeout. He took Jaden's hand and they went to go play basketball. And while they were playing basketball, Jaden finally opened up to Jose. And he used his words to tell why he was in a fight. And Jose stopped the game and hugged him right away. And he said, I'm hugging you not because you're in timeout. I'm hugging you not because you're in a fight. I'm hugging you because you used your words this time. Jose found himself thinking about Jaden a lot. He found himself wanting to spend more time with Jaden. But the next time he went to the center, Jaden was gone. And he had been placed yet in another home. But Jose writes that this encounter with Jaden changed his life. It changed him from an engineering major to becoming a major in family counseling and family services for families at risk. this Jaden changed the course, changed the direction of his life. And Jaden taught him an important lesson, a lesson that we are to meet children and people where they are at. He said, "It reminds me of God and how God meets us where we are at to bring to us the needs that we have." As we look to this passage that we have before us today, we see God's faithfulness. God's faithfulness to humanity that started at the very beginning of time. God's faithfulness as he comes to us and encounters us in our everyday life unexpectedly, undeservedly, as he rains his grace upon us day after day. His faithfulness to us brings us to a response. Brings us to a response to respond to others in the way that he would want us to, and a response to care for others. This word that God has brought to us in flesh through his Son, Jesus Christ, brings to us words of hope and words of promise and words of love. Might we, as we enter into this new year, know that God is raining down his grace on us, and might we respond in a way that will change the world. Amen.
This time I invite Kevin and Aaron and Miles, and Reese wants to come up here too. She can come up here. Whoever you want up here. I'm going to start on 228. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, to you, Aaron and Ryan, to you, Aaron and Kevin, desire to have Miles Thomas baptized into Christ.
We do.
As you bring Miles Thomas to receive the gift of baptism, you both are entrusted with responsibilities. To live with Miles among God's faithful people, to bring Miles to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach him the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments. Place in Miles' hands the Holy Scriptures, nurture him in faith and prayers so that he may learn to trust God. Proclaim Christ, the Word and Deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you both promise to help Miles Thomas grow in the Christian faith and life?
We do.
People of God, do you promise to support Miles Thomas and pray for him in his new life in Christ?
We do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
We renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin and that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death, and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. All right. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, you grunt and you groan. Hi, buddy. Hi, little guy. Yeah. Miles Thomas, I baptize you in the name of the Father. Oh, I know you're only in the name of the Son. In the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh, it's okay. It's okay. There we go. Let it out. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Miles Thomas with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence both now and forever. Miles Thomas, child of God, you've been sealed by the promise of the Holy Spirit, and you have been marked by the cross of Christ forever. Amen. Will you light his candle? Miles Thomas Anderson, let your light so shine before others that they will glorify your Father in heaven through your good works. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. I present you now our newest brother in Christ, Miles Thomas Anderson. There they are. Welcome, buddy. Because we're living in a time of COVID, we have supply issues. We normally would have a faith chest here to give to Miles for his journey through the faith stepping stones, but our supplier is not able to provide it at this time. So maybe in 6 months you might see the faith chest that's handmade by one of our members, but life happens. Anyhow, welcome. Take the handkerchief, certificate, and candles. Candle. I have to tip my book. Okay. We continue with our prayers.
Of heaven and for our salvation, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For peace in the whole world and peace among all peoples, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
Give wisdom and compassion, we pray to you,
O God of all the mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For all who work for justice and freedom from oppression, we pray to you,
O God of all the mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For rain, sun, and harvest, and food to fill the hungry, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For all who know affliction, despair, wrath, and danger, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For all those who suffer in grief, pain, and sorrow, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
For all our beloved, our family, friends, and neighbors, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
Rejoicing in communion with saints gone before us, we pray to you,
O God of love and mercy, and listen to our prayer.
God of love, hear our prayer. Amen.
To these petitions, O Lord, we lift up those who are on our prayer list. Particularly this day, we lift up Jackie, we lift up Les, Tammy, Alice. We lift up those recovering from recent surgeries, Kirk, Stephen, Logan, Tricia. We pray, O Lord, for all who are mourning, for all who are struggling. We lift up particularly the Koch family upon the death of Myra's father, Jacoba Medina. Again, may the hope of the resurrection bring comfort and courage. May the promise of life beyond death bring us comfort and courage for the days to face our own. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Trusting in your mercy, we offer our prayers in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to stand to receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our sending hymn, what a fellowship, what a joy divine. You may be seated as we prepare for holy.
Praise Him. This life, this heart, this soul.